Here we go. Notifications. Okay, that's good there. Got that good. Good, 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 good.
Good, good, good.
I was on another vacation. Nope, that's Mel this week. And by vacation, she's taking a rest because of this little thing called Corona.
The Rona.
She'll be all right. So she must have taken Pfizer then because she has two shots, right?
Pfizer or Moderna, one of the two.
Moderna's a...
That's a two also.
Two shot, yeah. I just hear Clay and Joe.
That's the only people here. That's... Unless, aside from me, Joe, and Mel, you also hear other people, which would be awesome. That which means your house is probably haunted.
Yeah. You probably should check your audio.
You should probably do something about that.
All right, am I going to show...
Maybe that's why you can't hear us all the time.
Yeah.
Oh, we usually have music? Oh, okay.
I mean, there is music. But it's separate audio.
Yeah. I don't have the stream audio on, so I can't, like, hear music anyway.
Oh.
I can see us on the stream, and that's it.
Yeah.
Wow, I have 10,470 nerdy points.
Yeah, don't you know? Let's see. Take that off. He's probably just trolling. There should be like faint music. It shouldn't be like super loud. Mic two. Notifications. There is music. What? Clay can't be muted. I see his voice meter go up and down, so. I can't hear Clay. Damn it, Mel. Video background, not needed. What the f- That's... All right. Let's see then. But you can hear music, just not Clay.
And I can hear the music, but I can't hear me.
How about try it now?
I'm back.
Okay. Can we get an audio guy here now? Fuck!
Anybody? Does anybody want to be an audio person?
Fuck! Fuck this thing.
Do we have any audio people?
I'll do graphics and video all day long. Don't ask me about audio. That's some imaginary person that hasn't joined the team yet.
Look, if we ever start getting paid for this thing, we'll cut you in if you're an audio person. It's okay. You'll be part of the staff and you'll get a cut. It's cool.
Just don't be that guy that's like, I need $500 for this thing that's only going to enhance your audio like 2%.
Yeah.
But it's like for the audio files, bro.
They're going to be like, you're going to be a star amongst all 8 people in the world who care about this thing.
Shit. I can be the audio guy. Not from there, you can't. You have to be in town, bro.
Yeah, he lives in like garbage California or something, right?
It's, why do I always have a hard time with that town name? It's a city. It's not Burbank.
Oh God, I was just in Burbank. What a shite hole.
Not with that attitude. What was it? Fuck. Bakersfield. Yeah.
Bakersfield? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so garbage California. Okay.
Yeah. I was literally taking a picture of that town all the way from the mountains.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like about 45 minutes away, but you can see the city lights. And I was like, oh, that's where my cousin lives. Yay! Mm-hmm. I'm not going there. Nope. I gotta go there once, though.
Just the worst state ever.
The state. It's going places. We'll see where. Aren't they, like, on a trench?
Who, Bakersfield?
No, California, like, has a huge trench somewhere.
I have no idea. The San Andreas Fault?
Yeah.
Which is, like... When you watch, like, I think that was where, like, in, like, Escape from L.A., it's, like, an earthquake happened, and then, like, Los Angeles broke away from the rest of the state.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mal Blue Eyes just subscribed.
Yay!
Woot! Wait a second.
Do we give anything for people
who subscribe? It's going to Hawaii when the fault gives out. Yeah, that's probably what's going to happen.
It's going to Hawaii. Do we have anything to give people when they subscribe to us? Like, any custom emotes or anything? We have one.
I don't know.
We have one custom emote.
And that's... Technically, we have 3, 4, I think, that I've uploaded already.
According to my thing, where it's like when I click on subscribe, it's like you get one, and it's Rage Pants.
Ah, that guy. There it is. Yeah. He tried to be slick about it and tried to pixelate the middle finger in that emoji. It still passed.
I mean, that's cool. Tell him to make more.
Yeah.
Where's he been?
Living under a rock.
Apparently.
Yeah. He's, where is this? Oh. He is busy right now learning everything about cybersecurity.
Ugh. Open log file, read, rinse, repeat.
I give you guys my Prime sub. Yay.
Well, thank you.
Now go to sleep.
Thank you.
Because that shot's going to be rough. You're going to feel weird.
See, I didn't... The only thing I got on my first one was, like, sore arm.
I got achiness all over it, but that was about it.
Yeah. The second one, that was, like, flu symptoms for, like, a few hours, and that was about it.
Yeah. Turn into zombies on that end.
Yeah.
All right, so we are at 11:52 right now. I think we are almost good to go. We got that going. All right. Joel, it's already a bitch, and this is already past 24 hours. Yep.
That's crazy.
Yep. I got both shots and just a sore arm, and that's it. That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a sore arm, but then I was, like, super tired, just sleepy.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it. It wasn't that bad. I was expecting, like, oh, I'm going to need an excuse to, like, just ball out and just, oh, I got to go. I can't go to work today or nothing like that.
Yeah.
You okay? You look confused.
Me?
Yeah.
I have an account on Twitter that I'm following, apparently, and I don't know what it is. Like, what,
I got the Pfizer.
Why am I following this?
Probably yeah, butt dialed it.
Possibly.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. That one. Woot.
I was thinking about putting this in the show notes, and I didn't, but it's like the when Mass Effect Legendary Edition came out, they like edited all of the cutscenes in Mass Effect 2 so it didn't focus on Miranda's butt all the time.
Oh yeah.
And so like and so some modder like modded them back in. It's like, of course.
Why not?
Yeah. I got the black lung pop. Joe, you work for me. That's
funny. I can see Joe calling in at work. Boss, I can't go to work today. I got the black lung. Cough, cough. Boss, Joe, you work from home. Ah, no. Yeah.
It's all good, Mel. You'll be fine. Just give it another day.
Yeah. And show up for work. And not your regular job. Us.
You'll be fine. You're okay. Doing good stuff for the world. Be part of the solution, I say.
There we go. All right. I got Pfizer as well, but it's giving me a major headache, nausea, and I had COVID already before. Oh, shit. Yeah, sometimes you are the issue, Clay.
Look, I am the issue when it comes to, like, why is he always right?
Is that it?
There's a problem here. Yeah.
I
gotta find a way. I gotta find a way to make him wrong. And it's like, not gonna happen.
So Mal had COVID before she got the vaccine.
Mm-hmm.
Oof. All right. Let us know if the music audio is overbearing or not. No trolling.
Hey, Joe.
All right. Hey, what's up, Raven?
Hey, Raven. Ahoy.
Yarg.
Yarg. Yarg. Scurvy.
We make that reference every time.
There's a guy on our team who dresses like a pirate?
Yeah. Steve.
Yeah. Steve the pirate. Yarg. Scurvy.
Oh, hey, Steve.
So good.
Who was that guy? That was,
The actor who played Steve the Pirate?
No, I know who the actor is. He's been in a shit ton of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Epic. Epic roles, really.
Well, so yeah, so like, no, well, yeah, the guy who plays Steve the Pirate is Alan Tudyk, is the actor. He's been in a million things. He's a voice actor also. If you're a giant nerd, you probably know him as Wash from Firefly and Serenity.
Yeah. He was the pilot, right?
Yeah.
And then he was also, wasn't he also in Mass Effect?
Like as a voice?
Yeah. I could have swore he was a science guy's voice, the big alien eyeball guy's voice, but I could be wrong.
Like Morden?
Mm-hmm. Could have swore that was him.
Same.
Poor Firefly, though. All I got at the very end was a movie to tie up some of the things that it was left behind with.
Yeah, I mean, the extended ending was, like, decent.
Yeah.
It helped. It's still a crappy ending, but it at least helped.
Yeah. All right. Where are we? 11:58? Let's do the game news. If anybody wants to send this out on your socials, we'd appreciate it.
The books.
Now that vacation time is over for me, it's time for me to get back on the horse and start working on this a little bit more.
Alan Tudyk.
No. He's not in there.
I'm looking. I
could be wrong. I don't know. I could have swore that was him, though.
That was back in, like, 2007 or something. Here, let's just do a search. Mass. No, he's not in it.
Damn. And then he did a new web series. Or not a web series. He did a new... a new series for sci-fi, I think.
Yeah, he's in one right now, that Resident Alien.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he's a cool actor. Fire. So I was, I know we have like a minute. I was in California like 2 weeks ago also for like a work thing. Mm-hmm. And our flight got canceled. So I just rented a car and drove back. But it was like, the lady at the rental car place was like, I was wearing like a Star Wars face mask. Yeah. And she was like, oh yeah, I love Star Wars and all this stuff. And we're just kind of like chatting and stuff while she's, you know, typing everything in. And I was like, yeah, you know, big nerd, video games, all that stuff. She goes, yeah, me too. I love all that stuff. And she goes, but primarily I'm a brown coat, which means that she's a Firefly fan. And I was like, cause like, that's what they call themselves. And I was like, oh, that's awesome. Like I loved Firefly. I love Serenity. Great stuff. And I was like, but you know what? I have a question for you. And I was like, are you still like keeping up with that universe? And she's like, oh yeah, like I'm in message boards and you know, all that stuff. And I'm like, okay, what are the Firefly fans, like all the brown coats, what is their opinion? Since like, it turns out Joss Whedon is like a huge douchebag in real life. And it was like, cause that like, this was a thing that happened like 2 months ago or something like that, where it was like, he's just a dick. And it was like, and it's like, oh, and she basically, and I thought it was like a very good answer. She goes, kind of like JK Rowling. It was like, we just kind of acknowledge, like, we just kind of acknowledge that Firefly happened and Serenity happened, and they just kind of appeared out of nowhere.
Nobody really pushed it over to anything. Yeah.
It was just like, kind of like Harry Potter. We just go, it's there. Yeah. And it was like, oh yeah, who made that? Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
It's
there. Yeah. Yeah.
I thought it was really funny.
Pee-wee's Playhouse? Yeah, yeah, yeah. We love that movie. Except for when he wanks it.
That wasn't in that movie.
No.
That was in a different movie.
Yeah.
Theater.
Mm-hmm.
When look, man, the guy made fun of himself for it. I'm all about it.
Who?
Paul Rubens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, I still can't forget him as this. What was it? This. No. Was it the Sphinx? No. Mystery Men.
In Mystery Men. Dude, you know what? Yeah, I've only seen that movie like once ever.
What?
Yeah,
that movie's awesome.
It was funny. I'll say that, but it's not one that I go back to like constantly or anything. I think his best role, and we're gonna go back to Joss Whedon for a second. The movie Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Mm-hmm.
Paul Rubens is in it. He plays like the number two guy to the villain, and it's like there's a scene where like so
what.
The main villain is played by Rutger Hauer, and he's like the head vampire guy. His number two guy is Paul Rubens' character, and I don't even know his character's name or anything, but he's like this like sidekick vampire guy. And when Buffy kills him, it is this super long, drawn out like death scene, and it is hilarious.
Where, okay, like, now I gotta check out this clip.
She stabs him with like a ruler. You know, because it's like made out of wood, right? And he's like, boom! And he's all like, ah! Ah! Ooh! Ee!
Oh my goodness.
It's like, it is so funny. And yeah. I'm like, that is the funniest part of that movie. I know we are 2 minutes over now, by the way. We should probably start this thing.
All right, you ready?
Yeah. I'm just going to pull up the clip and put it in the chat, just so, you know right. For words.
All right, let's do this then.
It's that time for our weekly Game News Live podcast. Be a part of the show by joining us at nerdduggies.com/Twitch. Live Saturdays at 12 noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern. With your host, console fanboy, our resident OG, and on the stream, switchboard, Joel. This is
Welcome everyone to Game News Live.
Hello everyone, welcome. I'm totally distracted by watching this scene. This
Buffy the Vampire death scene.
If anybody out there has seen the movie version of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, I'm going to put it in entertainment chat on our Discord.
All right.
Just because.
Should I open
we're
it?
We're talking about it on the stream. Boom. And you're going to be like, what is this?
All right.
It's a really crappy quality, too. It's not even like a Blu-ray rip or anything like that.
All right, let's take a look.
We were talking about like Paul Reubens, the guy, you know, Pee-wee's Playhouse and like Mystery Men, the movie a second ago. We're totally off track right now, but you know, I was just like,
just run it. I'm putting it up now. Let's take a look at this thing.
So this is Rutger Hauer playing like the main villain. Here we go. This is just so stupid. So he's like, are you going to save me? And he's like, no. And he's like, ah!
Ew.
Hold on. Yep.
Yeah.
We probably shouldn't have audio. Yeah, for copyright claims,
you gotta check it. And he's kicking the wall. Oh my god!
And I'm just like, it's so dumb. That scene, it's like the funniest part of the movie, right there. So stupid. So video games, right, Joe?
Video games, yeah.
Video games.
All right.
I love tangents. They're the greatest.
All right, let's get started with new releases because we got to get through those. Huh?
This is the kind of entertainment you get on Nerd Junkies, people. Yeah,
We go all over the place.
All right. Somebody in the chat's going to post one thing and it's like, ooh, I got a clip for that.
Yeah.
It's the greatest.
All right. Available on July 16th, Zelda Skyward Sword HD is available on Nintendo Switch.
This is a Switch exclusive. Obviously, it's a Zelda game, but it's, you know, it's not coming to 3DS or anything like that. This is a re-release of the previous Wii game. This was the big Wii Motion Plus game back in the day. I think we've already talked about this a couple times when they first announced it. It's possibly one of the best Zelda stories there is, and the gameplay is very...
Do you think it deserved an HD remake, though, with Switch?
No,
or they should have kept the original?
No. To me, the game isn't good enough to get a remake, but I realize this is Nintendo we're talking about, and they want to HD re-release everything so they can just double dip and get all your money.
It just feels like they've just milked the crap out of these titles at this point.
Well, because they know people will buy them, right? Like,
and they're targeting a new generation, too.
They're targeting people who maybe, like Zelda fans who played Breath of the Wild, who maybe didn't, like they were too young to play it on the Wii when it came out.
Right.
And they're going to be like, oh my God, I love Breath of the Wild. Let's get that next.
Right.
This is Nintendo. This is what they do. They re-release the same stuff over and over again and people buy it. And I'm one of those chumps, so no judgment, right?
Yeah.
This is possibly one of the first Zelda games re-releases anything that I'm not gonna buy, because I still have my copy on the Wii and it was not my favorite Zelda game, and I do not ever want to go through it again. Like, this is a Zelda game that I'm good. Like, I beat it, I got the story. If I want to rewatch the story, which is great, I'll YouTube it,
right?
You know, like, that's it. Like, I'm out after that. Like, this game was not my favorite, like, gameplay wise and it's like, I'm good. But for anybody out there who hasn't played it, like I said, it does have a really good story. You're just going to have to fight through a lot of frustrating gameplay to get there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Would anyone in the chats actually buy the re-release, the HD release of Skyward Sword for your Switch?
I know a ton of people who are buying this. A ton of people who are buying this. They're buying the Amiibo because we talked about a few weeks ago. They're releasing a special Amiibo. I think it's like $25.
Uh-huh.
And it's... It allows you to fast travel in the game. So kind of like most Zelda games where they have kind of like a binary system. Like, you're either in the past or the future, or the light world, the dark world, stuff like that. This one is, you're either in the clouds in this little area called Skyloft, or you're in the ground, like in Hyrule.
Right.
And normally you have to find like a save point, where, you know, to be able to fast travel like back and forth. But with this amiibo, it just instantly allows you to do it. So it's kind of a pay to win mechanic, but it's not really pay to win because it's a single player game. They're just giving you a little more convenience.
Gotcha.
Raven says, never played Skyward Sword. Like I said, fantastic story. This is actually, interestingly enough, if you know anything about the Zelda timeline, which is just crazy, this is the first game in the timeline. So, like, this is the original Zelda game. Like, this kicks off everything. And then you get, like, Ocarina of Time, which then breaks the timeline into, like, three paths. But this takes place before that. So this is, like, the origin story of everything.
Right.
Like I said, great story. Nothing against the story. But if you never played it on the Wii when it came out, check it out. Let us know what you think. You'd be like, Clay, that game was awesome. You're stupid. And I'll be like, okay.
All right. Let's move on to the next one. Next one is going to be F1 2021. And I believe this one is up for pre-order. But when is it being released?
All of these games are very normal video game release cycle. It's either going to be Tuesday or Friday.
Well, I have seen Thursday sometimes, but that was just like a weird release.
Is it Thursday or like a Thursday midnight kind of thing?
It could be a Thursday midnight. But I know people have been like lining up for some of the games, and I'm just like, but there's digital now. I could only see like collectors doing that. You know what I mean? They're not.
Yeah, I can see that.
They're not really like there for the digital release or just to get the first of everything. They're there for the physical copy.
That's me, bro.
Yeah,
all
that's
day.
You. But yeah, F1 2021 is coming out.
Formula One.
Yeah.
If anybody out there plays those games, I certainly do not.
I used to play them on PC, but that's about it.
I know racing games have a really big following. Mm-hmm. Like, there are just diehard racing people out there. That's why these games keep coming out. Like, you'd be like, who plays Formula One games? No. If nobody played Formula One games, you wouldn't see this game right now.
There wouldn't be any release.
Like, there is a community of people who, like, love these games.
I've seen some people actually, like, build an entire rig around a game just so that way they can
A buddy of mine actually does that for there's a game on the PC it's pretty popular on Twitch if you ever look at it. It's called iRacing. And a buddy of mine, he has like a whole like sit-in car thing that he does, like, with steering wheel and everything. And I'm like, dude, that's okay, man.
That's devotion.
More power to you, bro.
Should get him to put in some 2 cents on some car games, man.
Yeah, I could.
I don't think we really have anyone who's like a race car game fan.
Well, not race cars when it comes to like your Formula Ones or your NASCAR games or anything like that. But I do have a couple buddies who religiously get Gran Turismo games when they come out, or the Forza games when they come out.
Yeah.
Which, if you're a Game Pass subscriber, you're going to get like all the Forza games anyway. If you're a PlayStation person, then they, you know, swear by Gran Turismo. It's like, you know, the holy grail of car racing stuff.
Yeah.
Which I've tried to play like twice ever, and I was like, oh, it's like a real car game? Like, no, bro. I need Mario Kart or like GTA physics. Like, I just need like full speed and then you know, hairpin turn, you know, like give me that, you know? Like, I'm not about this, like, oh, you mean I have to slow down when I'm turning?
You're more of an arcade racer, huh?
Arcade racers all day. I remember it was a couple months ago. No, it was at E3. Nintendo, I think it was during Nintendo's press conference or their like Nintendo Direct thing, they showed off a new Cruisin' USA game. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh my God, I used to love Cruisin' USA. Like, this, like, it's just like an arcade racer, you know? And I was like, oh my God, so fun.
Yeah. Looks like Rage Pants subscribed for 5 months. Thanks for the subscription. Wow.
Woot. Now, Rage Pants, I bet you're wondering, how many custom Nerd Junkies emotes am I going to get out of there for subscribing to 5 months? Well, as it turns out, we only have one.
I mean, I uploaded the other ones, so.
One. Rage Pants. One.
Are you saying now that he paid us in 5 month subscriptions, he's on the hook for more emotes?
He just paid himself to make us more emotes.
Got it. Yeah. Incentivized. So, yeah.
If you could just get on that, that'd be super.
Right.
No, I thought you uploaded, yeah, it was like the Kratos one.
Yeah,
and then
the secret one is actually Ben.
Okay. Because
no one ever gets to see Ben. He's like a secret character.
So where's like...
He's like Mr. X.
Okay. Okay, yeah, you're right. So, okay, so for... It says one custom emote, which is Rage, and then I see there's like Baby Mel, and then you.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, where's Ben? Like, how do people unlock that?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Have to find out.
Twitch, bro.
Twitch.
Twitch.
Yeah. All right. You ready for the next one?
I'm always ready for this. I'm pumped for this next one.
All right. Fans of Streets of Rage 4 are getting a Mr. X Nightmare DLC. It's going to be released on July 15th.
Yeah.
If you guys are fans of beat-em-ups, this is where it's at.
Normally, I don't put a lot of like DLC on new release days unless it's like something just special.
Yeah.
And Streets of Rage 4 is that something special. This game is so fun. If you all haven't played Streets of Rage, any of the series, highly recommended. They were old like Sega Genesis games, Mega Drive games, depending on where you live. Beat 'em ups, brawlers, 90s beat 'em up games, which are my bread and butter. That is my favorite genre of video game there is. Streets of Rage 1, 2 were some of the best games ever made. 3 was, but 4, awesome. They brought it back.
Yeah,
4 is good.
They went a completely different art style too, and it looks polished.
It's gorgeous, right? And they really upped the combat in these games too. So they actually, it has more of kind of like a fighting game combo system now with like just tons of juggles and combos that you can do. This DLC, so the Streets of Rage game, or 4, came out, I think it was last year, and it's on Game Pass. So if you're a Game Pass subscriber, it is on there. If not, it's also available basically everywhere, PC, Switch, PS4, whatever. This is just their first big DLC pack. It's got, from what Joe's watching right here, a survival mode, just kind of like endless levels that get harder and harder, but you can level up your character. We've got 3 new playable characters. You've got Sheila, who is always kind of like the number 2 bad guy. You've got Max, who's back from Streets of Rage 2. He's technically in 4 already, just not as a playable character. And now you've got Estelle, who is a boss character that you fight multiple times in the game. And pumped, man. I'm excited. I hope the DLC comes to Game Pass. If not, I also own the game on the Switch, and I'll probably just buy it anyway for that.
Yeah.
Because this is... Streets of Rage 4 is just a phenomenally good game. Co-op. It has online co-op. Play with your friends.
Did you say anything about the any crossplay capabilities on this game?
Unfortunately, no crossplay that I've seen.
That'd be a perfect game to do it on, though.
Unless it's something like maybe Xbox to PC, but I don't think there is actually. Like, I think it's just like whatever platform you're on with that. It isn't like a huge budget game anyway. But so like it doesn't surprise me that it doesn't have all the bells and whistles, but I mean, this game is just, it's so fun anyway. And then now that they're just adding more to it, I'm just like, yes, yeah. Keep going. Like more and more and more Streets of Rage.
Max Thunder seems like a move copy of Mr. What's his name from the old one?
Like Hagar from Final Fight?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The way he grabs people, it's just like that 2-frame delay. Just bam.
Yeah, I mean, they're both ex-pro wrestlers,
mm-hmm.
So which is why they're so huge. They're slow. They hit really hard. A lot of speedrunners of Streets of Rage 2, they play as Max because even though he moves really slow, he can crush people like super fast.
Yeah.
And so like you're clearing screens of enemies faster than like what anybody else can do. So yeah, like a lot of people play him for that. Super fun. Can't wait. Pumped. Streets of Rage is amazing. Hey, Yogensha. How we doing, buddy?
What up, Yogensha?
Yeah.
This guy looks like almost a direct copy in some of his moves.
Yeah. Mike Hagar.
Yeah.
The mayor.
Yeah, but I can also see like he covers almost like a quarter of the screen. Mm-hmm. It's pretty big.
Yeah. It's so good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, moving on to game news, shall we? Or this is actually rumor control. Right. So if you were expecting some Grand Theft Auto 6, there is rumor that that is possibly not going to be out for another, what, 2 years?
4 years.
Oh, okay.
So this is all rumor. This is nothing. Like, Rockstar has yet to announce a single thing. Rockstar has yet to even acknowledge GTA 6 is being made. That's how, like this
what,
is...
What would they this have, is the, though?
This is the video game version of the Switch Pro, which we're going to get to later. Okay, it's like I'm sure they're working on GTA 6, but Rockstar hasn't even said they're working on it. So it's like, but jeez. Everybody says, "Ooh, new GTA 6 rumor. Oh, I saw a leaked map. It's going to have this guy in it. It's going to be whatever." There's nothing. This is a article on Destructoid that just kind of brings in a few articles. This was actually a Bloomberg article, but as we've mentioned in the past, Bloomberg charges for their website. So we're not linking you directly to them. But this report basically says Rockstar's working on it. It's taking its time. They're still making a fortune off GTA 5, which if you remember, there's going to be another re-release of later this year. And basically, Rockstar got in trouble a few years ago about crunch. And if you don't know what that is, that means when video games are being made, there's a very strict timetable. And so they basically say, hey, this game needs to release in the next 6 months. And then maybe the dev team goes, it's not ready. It's going to take a year. And they go, make it happen. And it basically, everybody then at that point starts working 20-hour days, 7 days a week. And that's called crunch. And Rockstar got in a lot of trouble for it a few years ago because apparently they crunch hard on their games. Like Red Dead 2, GTA 4, and 5 were big examples of this. And it was a lot of bad press. So this article suggests that they are taking their time so their people can have better lives, which is admirable. Like, I'm not complaining about that being the reason why these games are taking so long. We just don't know if that's actually true or not. Mm. Or if that's just like a positive spin on some of this. We don't know.
Sure.
But yeah, multiple sources have confirmed, like, yeah, GTA 6 is a while away. Nobody should be getting ready to play it this year, next year, or anything like that. If anything, the PS5 Series X version of 5 comes out in November. You can just play that.
Yeah.
Again, for the third console.
I mean, cool. We're getting at least a more polished version than what you got now, but even the stuff that runs now, it's pretty good. I mean,
yeah,
it does all the backward compatibility stuff, but I don't know what else you could do to GTA 5 to really sell it.
So I will say this as console guy, it runs good on the PS4. Mm-hmm. It runs slightly less than good on the Xbox, and the 360 versions, PS3 versions, those are dead in the water anyway. But if they can at least get better frame rates out of the console versions, people are going to be happy.
Yeah.
Like 4K 60, that would be amazing.
I just don't know if that's enough to rebuy the game, though.
Oh, it's definitely not enough for me. I've already beat the game like 3 times. I have it on the PS3 and the PS4. I'm not buying this again.
Yeah, Dark has the key right here.
I'm out.
It ain't about the frame rates. Just make it load faster.
If they can make it load faster, which these new consoles are capable of that. So Joe and I were talking before the show. I think I mentioned this a week or two or three ago, the last time we played this, we did a show. I'm going through GTA 4 again because it's been a long time since I've played it. GTA 4 on the 360 had some really brutal load times also. And playing it on the Series X, like, instant. Like, the load times are, like, non-existent now. So even if, like, yeah, GTA games are known for big load times. It happens. Like, look at, like, Red Dead 2. Red Dead 2 has brutal load times. But, which I haven't tried Red Dead 2 on my PS5. I should probably do that just to see if it loads, like, way faster. I think Red Dead 2 is also on Game Pass. I might just download it. I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah.
But, by the way, Yogensha has basically the best comment in the entire series of this show. He goes, nothing can top Vice City anyway.
I mean, yeah.
Right there.
That's I don't know if they would ever go back to what would be their Miami, right?
Well, according to this article, all of these three sources are agreeing. What they're hearing is we're going back to Vice City.
Hmm.
And it's like, I'm okay with that. Grand Theft Auto Vice City is one of my favorite games ever made.
But so Vice City, Vice City in the current state or in the past, like how they've been doing in the right? Like,
yeah.
I wonder if they would pay a lot of respect to some of the things that happened in Vice City.
Well,
by doing it modern and then just changing things up.
I don't think they will. And okay. There would be probably an Easter egg here and there. But if you remember, once GTA 4 happened, they kind of disconnected all the previous games. Mm. So like GTA 4 took place in Liberty City, which is where GTA 3 took place. And it was a completely different city, completely different characters. Nobody referenced anything except people on the radio. That was it. There was like, even like the names of the islands were different. It was like, it was a whole new city. Nobody saw anything. But then you had like some carryovers on the radio. So you had like Laszlo was back and Fernando Martinez was back and, you know, stuff like that. But that was it. And then when 5 came out, 5 took place in Los Santos, which is where San Andreas was. There was like, technically Grove Street is there, but there was no like gang, you know,
right.
Like, you know, like they're
almost like we're talking about
TJ
like,
wasn't there. Yeah.
Like an alternate universe.
Yeah, or like you could say like a parallel universe where they just like they acknowledge like a few Easter eggs here and there, but there was no like actual connection between the older games and these games.
Hmm.
So even if GTA 6 does take place in Vice City, hopefully it'll be in the 80s again. But if not, it'll be they might have like, I don't know, just a building or a statue or a name of a street or something like that. Like Versetti Avenue or something like that, you know, like who knows?
Yeah, just paying little respects to the originals, right?
Yeah, just Easter egg stuff, you know.
I mean, it's cool when they do that, but not required.
I love that stuff.
I think just I seeing Vice City and the current gen of things and not trying to make it work on the Xbox One, you know what I mean? Like, please stop doing
GTA 6. GTA 6 better be just on these newer consoles. Right. Like it should like I get it. 14 billion people have PlayStation 4s and Xbox Ones right now. Yeah, sorry. Leave them in the past.
Right.
Okay.
like
you need to make this game as good as it possibly can be.
I think
you can only do that if you cut all the old stuff.
I think Dark has it right. Just make it load faster because everything else already looks pretty enough.
Yeah. Make it load faster. These new consoles, man, the load times are so good.
Not you, Cyberpunk.
I love it. I was talking to my buddy Brian, who is still playing Cyberpunk on his mm-hmm. PS4 Pro,
mm-hmm.
and knowing how broken it is, and it is still a mess. That game is still a mess, even though like CD Projekt said, like the console versions are in a satisfactory state right now, and it's like, no, dude, it's still a mess. Like these games are still crap.
Satisfactory enough to get him past the legal requirement for not getting sued.
Yeah, so like he just got a Series X the other day, and he was like, yeah, I think I might like buy a copy of Cyberpunk on the Xbox so I can see what it looks like on this. And I'm like, no, it's still an Xbox One game. It's not even a Series X game yet. Like, you're gonna get faster load times and maybe a few less crashes, but it's not ready yet.
Just
give it like a year and see what happens, right?
Yeah. So Yagenta says, I have a feeling the next gen versions are gonna get canceled.
I do not think CD Projekt is ready for that kind of backlash. Because, yeah, so like The Witcher 3, which we're gonna get to this later, is about to get a next version of, or like a next gen upgrade, which is great. Yeah, we'll get to that way later in the show. But like, they would be even more foolish than they are now if they were to cancel the PS5 Series X versions, because like that, yeah, it was just like that would send such a bad message if they just gave up.
You think they wouldn't survive it if they did?
I think they would survive it because they're making so much money off The Witcher, it doesn't matter.
But then they turn into another Blizzard at that point.
Oh yeah, no, like they would survive it, but their reputation is already like tanked from where they were a year ago.
Yeah, that's
like everybody loved them. If you remember, they were like the most favorite game developer in the world.
Yeah,
like their fandom was huge because of the way they treat everybody. Like people like good old games, you know, like, you know, GOG it's a good website. DRM free, everything, like, you get all these old games that work in Windows 10, stuff like that. Cool. And they treat their people good. Good DLCs. All their DLCs are free. You know, it was like, and then they did Cyberpunk and ruined everything. So, like, I don't think they're willing to tank their reputation even more than it already is.
Yeah. Yeah, Yurgencha also says, I think people mostly stopped giving a crap about 2077 already, so I don't know if it's worth making a new version for them.
Well, keep in mind, and I know I'm going to be the broken record here, Witcher 3 was pretty broken when it came out, and then they did patch after patch after patch, and they fixed it. And then people were like, oh man, The Witcher 3 is amazing now. And now it's like everybody's favorite game of all time is The Witcher 3. And it's like, that's cool. Like, I went through it. It's a good game. It's buggy, but it's good. But it's like, I think that's what they're doing now. Like, they're going to build Cyberpunk back up to a good state and then be like, okay, everybody, try it now. And then people are going to be like, oh, Cyberpunk's actually really good now.
It is what it is, but we'll have to wait and see.
Witcher 3 combat sucks. I wouldn't say sucks. I'll just say I've played better.
It's convoluted, though.
I've played better and I've played worse.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll say that.
All right. Let's move on to the next one. Bluebird Team denies recent Silent Hill concept speculation.
So
more rumor, huh?
Bluebird Team just came out with this game last year called The Medium, which is a PC and Xbox timed exclusive. So it's on Game Pass if you have Game Pass. I know, dude, I'm just going to sound like a shill for Xbox and Game Pass now. So Microsoft, if you want to, you know.
They don't need you.
They're like, yeah, we get billions of viewers over here and you get two. Okay, all right. Yeah. And I'm going to be like, yeah, but throw me some of that ducats, you know? Okay, so Bluebird Team came out with The Medium and it's a psychological horror game. Wasn't bad. I watched my buddy Cinder can go through it because, you know, scary. It actually releases on the PS5 next year. So, or later this year or something like that. I don't know. Because it's time to exclusivity is going to be up, which that's fine. Decent game, very Silent Hill-ish, creepy, psychological stuff like that. They announced a partnership, not an acquisition or a buyout or anything like that, but a partnership with Konami, who owns Silent Hill. So instantly everybody was like, they're making the new Silent Hill. Yeah, because that's what the internet does, right? That's them. Half-Life 3 confirmed. You know, like, it's basically that's what happened. Bluebird Team has basically, they did an interview with IGN. I am linking, or Joe's linking, the Destructoid article here because I hate IGN. and I don't want to give them clicks because screw them.
Yeah.
But they basically had an interview and they said, oh, you guys are making Silent Hill, right? And they were like, no. And they were like, well, what about these three games that you all have in the works right there? And they were like, that one got canceled. That one got canceled. And this one has nothing to do with Silent Hill. So it's like, I still think it's going to be Silent Hill.
You still think it's going to happen, huh?
I think this is one of those like Kojima fakeouts, you know, where it's like, no, I think it's actually still going to be Silent Hill because it would be, okay, Konami has to have a Silent Hill being made right now. I even though they have proven themselves to be complete idiots over the past few years, they have to. It would be impossible for there not to be a secret Silent Hill game being made right now. And Bluebird Team, maybe they brought them in to help out, or like, you know, like maybe they're going to shift the, you know, devs over to them or something like that. I don't know. Speaking of timed exclusive, this is Yogetcha. Can I get Tony Hawk on Steam already? FFS. Is that Epic exclusive or something?
Not sure.
Or is it not on PC? I thought it was. Like,
I could have swore it's on. I could have swore it's on Epic.
EGS exclusive. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, look, I know we've had this talk a few times, PC gamers. Okay. Is it really that big of a deal to buy a game from the Epic Game Store? Would you rather not play the game just to spite Epic?
I'm probably going to stand alone on this, but I usually like to keep my library in one single client.
I'm just saying, for us people, if a game comes, if Uncharted is a PlayStation exclusive, I buy it on the PlayStation. If Gears of War is an Xbox exclusive, I buy it on the Xbox because I want to play the game.
It's just inconvenient. That's all it is.
It's like
it sucks that I have to have.
It has zero features. Okay, does it play the game? If you launch the game, does it run? And you can then, you know, okay, by the way, Tony Hawk 1 and 2 HD remaster is amazing. I went through it on the PS4. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Is it going to play the game and it's going to give you 60 frames or more and it's going to play one of the greatest video game soundtracks ever made? Is it going to do that?
I mean, yeah.
Then what the problem is?
Problem is, I got to keep updating damn Epic Game Store client every single 5 days, and I don't want to do that.
Doesn't Steam update like every 5 minutes anyway?
Yeah, but it's just the king of all my library at this point.
I'm just saying. Good lord, it is not that big of a deal.
I know.
If you just have a problem with Epic because I don't know, Fortnite, or they canceled Unreal, or you know, like Epic versus Apple, or free Fortnite, all that crap, that's fine. Like, take a stand. I know people who refuse to buy Sony products and they're like, they will never get these Uncharted games or Metal Gear Solid 4 or anything like that because they refuse to. They're like, I hate Sony and or screw Microsoft.
It has zero to do with the client. Mel has it right here. Problem is, it's all PC games versus Xbox or PlayStation.
Uh-huh.
It's PC regardless, right? Yeah. So why are we having different clients for everything? And it always comes back to money. It's always like, oh, use our client so we can steal your information as you play.
Like, they're all stealing your information anyway. But it's like, so Yuga just says, I don't feel like having a separate client for like two games. I also like achievements, friends lists, and trading cards. EGS has none of that. Friends lists, that makes sense to me. If you're going to play a multiplayer game, if you're going to play Tony Hawk and or whatever, and you want to play multiplayer, I get it. That friends list is going to come in handy. Trading cards, useless. Achievements, feed your ego, bro. That's it. Like, that's all they're there for. All right. Yeah. You know, like, it, achievements are there just to feed your own ego, your own bragging rights. PC achievements at that. You can cheat any PC game very easy and get all the achievements, so there's no credibility to those at all. So, like, I get it. If you just hate Epic, that makes sense to me, but for everybody who's like, screw the exclusivity.
Screw that company.
It's, like, it's fine.
Yeah.
It's fine.
We'll get over it after
play
release.
Play the game. Play the game and enjoy it. It's amazing.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Yeah.
All right. So Games Done Quick, our next news article. It's going on right now. I think today's the last day, right?
Today's the last day. It started last Sunday. Games Done Quick, if you guys ever watch this, and I do this because I'm a big speedrun fan myself. I watch a lot of speedruns, especially in my spare time. Or if I'm working from home that day, I usually just have them on in the background, just random speedruns of retro games and stuff. Games Done Quick, it's a twice a year marathon. They support charities. So any donations you send in, if you want to go to their website, gamesdonequick.com, or any bits you cheer to them or any subscriptions, everything like that, all the money goes to a specific charity. Usually it's the Prevent Cancer Foundation or the Doctors Without Borders, which that's the one going on right now for Summer Games Done Quick. Everything is on YouTube also. You don't have to, you know, instantly stop watching us and go to Twitch. Please don't. But but it's good. Like, these marathons are really cool. If you've never been into speedruns or you don't even know what they are, it's people playing video games very, very fast.
Right.
So, like, if you can think of some super hard games that you were never able to beat because of one reason or another, these guys and gals beat those games within a matter of minutes, and you're kind of like, how the crap did they do that? That's awesome. To me, this is like, I love watching this stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, it, like I said, it's going on right now. It's going to be for the rest of today. It's on their schedule, it says it ends tonight at like midnight something. So these usually run a little longer anyway. So maybe like 1 or 2 a.m. Pacific, something like that. But yeah, good stuff. A lot of good speedruns. Everybody should watch these. They're great.
All right.
It's a different story. Uses Yoga Genshin. If every game was on every store instead of buying exclusivity rights with giant bags of money, that's video games, man. That's like, why do you think the Medium was an Xbox exclusive for a year? Money. Why is Death Stranding a PlayStation and PC exclusive? money. It's like, that's the video game industry, man. You just got to get used to it.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Our industry is terrible, but we have to live in it, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. All right, let's move on to the next one. It looks like NetherRealms is already dropping the rest of the support for Mortal Kombat 11.
I wouldn't say already. I would say finally.
Why? Didn't they just drop a DLC for it?
No, that's what I'm saying. So they have been supporting MK11 for like almost 2 years now or something like that. Like new characters, new, you know, skins, you know, like RoboCop and Terminator and Freddy Krueger and Jason Voorhees, you know, like all this, like all these crazy DLC packs, Ninja Turtles, things like that. And now they even, if you remember, they did like a, I forgot what they called, Afterlife or something like that, where they added like a whole new section to the campaign story.
Right.
Like a new ending and all that stuff. And they basically announced, okay, guys, we're done. Like we're going to move on, which is probably going to be like Injustice 3 or something like that. That's, you know, because right now they're just kind of flipping Mortal Kombat and Injustice games, which Injustice is cool too, so I get it. But yeah, this is them finally saying, we're done, we're out. And it's like, cool. MK11 is still pretty popular. People like it. There's a lot of streams going on for it. I believe it's going to be at Evo this year. That's cool. Like, MK11 was a decent game. So, like, good for you guys, NetherRealm. Way to go, Ed Boon. Way to...
Yeah, I liked
it. Turn out another gruesome, violent game.
My son played it more than I did, but definitely, I think Yogensha has it right here. MK11, people came for the crossovers.
Yeah,
they came for all the characters that were post DLC and all that other stuff. So
yeah,
they were fun.
Which is like I mentioned, like RoboCop and Terminator. So it's like, yeah, that's cool. Like, you want to see how they would fight in a fighting game? Sure.
I didn't see Rambo being one of them, but
Rambo's in there, and I thought that was a weird call. But I from what I heard, they got Stallone to actually voice him in the game, and what? I was like, that's cool.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. They didn't get Schwarzenegger or what's the guy's name? The RoboCop guy, Peter something. It's like.
Yeah.
They didn't get them, I don't think. Blade for MK12, as long as it's not Wesley Snipes. Ooh, I said it. That's right.
What?
That's right. I said it.
Why?
Those Blade movies were terrible. That's why.
I liked them. I liked that.
Those movies
stuff.
Were awful. I love cheesy action movies, and those were even too bad for that. Okay, those movies were awful. They're doing a Blade like TV series or something. Like Disney announced that like a year or two ago or something like that. It's like. Bring that guy into it, whatever, who cares?
Yeah.
Or if Wesley Snipes is going to do it, bring Simon Phoenix into the game.
Simon Phoenix
from Demolition Man.
Oh, okay.
One
gotcha.
Of the greatest action movies of all time.
Oh my god. Alright, let's move on to the next one. So I'm pretty sure everybody's heard it already about the Nintendo Switch re-release with
oh
the
my god
OLED.
Joe, are you ready? Joe, are you ready for the Switch Pro?
Yeah.
Are you ready for your 4K? Your 60 FPS?
Sounds delicious. Cool. New NVIDIA chipset
in it.
I'm going
to play, you know, VR compatible. It makes you a sandwich in the morning.
Yeah, the most mediocre upgrade ever, Yogensha. So,
I cannot believe they... Okay. There are Switch revisions that happen. There's already been one. It's like the you know, hardware upgrades happen, right?
Yeah.
Like it's a newer chipset gets made or something, like maybe it's even smaller now or it runs cooler or better battery life or something.
Yeah.
Like they're like consoles upgrade. There was like the 360 and then the Slim and then the E and then the G. And then, you know, it's like things like this happen. But normally upgrades aren't part of that cycle, right? So it's like, it's just, oh yeah, this is cheaper to make now, so we're gonna like revise everything. People have been talking for years about a Switch Pro that can run 4K. And it's like, cool. Nintendo's not known for pushing the boundary on graphics. They never have been. But like, when the prime example I give here is Hyrule Warriors, which is that Koei Tecmo like Dynasty Warriors game that takes place with Zelda and stuff. when that game released on the 3DS, it ran like crap. Like, it was slow and super slow frames. It lagged, everything like that. And then Nintendo released the new 3DS, which had which everything was stronger, everything was faster, and it ran that game well. Hyrule Warriors: Age of Calamity is on the Switch right now, and it runs like crap. It does. Like, even now, it runs terribly. It has really bad frame rates. And so people were like, Switch Pro, do it like the new 3DS, or give us the new Switch, or whatever. Like, make, like, give us some more power in the background so we can at least run this game like a normal steady frame rate. We get the Switch OLED. It's a 7-inch OLED screen. That's it.
But you forgot the kickstand, though.
Oh, yeah. So, okay, look. And I don't have my Switch here. My Switch is downstairs. Okay. I have a Switch. I've had one since day one. I have the old kickstand. The kickstand works. It holds the Switch up. If you pull it out and you sit it down, it stands. And what's cool about it is if it breaks off, it snaps right back in. It's not like a piece of plastic that it's like once it's off, it's off. No, yeah. It has like these little metal balls with like springs, and it just clips right back in. The kickstand is not hard. This is like when Nintendo had to re-release the wrist straps for the Wiimote, because right. People kept like chucking their Wiimotes into their TVs and stuff, and it's like, this is an unnecessary upgrade.
Okay, what about...
The kickstand worked.
What about the built-in LAN port?
The LAN port on the dock is a smart move for them, and that's because, well, so one, you can just buy a USB to Ethernet adapter, and yeah. It works fine.
Yeah.
But this is a good move for them because they have such a big online audience with like Smash players and especially like Monster Hunter Rise players.
Mm-hmm.
This is really good. The Splatoon players are gonna like this. You know, like with Splatoon 3 coming out,
very
next year,
competitive
like,
games that require yeah, that low band, that, low ping and all that stuff.
Yeah, like better than Wi-Fi. You know, like that's what they need for this. The Ethernet port was a good move. But then again, you could just buy a $20 USB to Ethernet adapter and you're good. You know,
so like, how much of a bump are we talking about then? In price? Yeah.
$50. So you're from the regular Switch. So there's Switch, and then there's Switch Lite, which is like just handheld mode. And then now there's Switch OLED, which I'm just calling the Swole. So it's like... the Swole is a Tree Fitty. Yeah. I mean, okay. About Tree Fitty.
So I thought the original yeah. Nintendo Switch was selling for $200.
The Switch Lite is selling for $200.
Oh, that's the one without the dock yeah. and everything, right?
The dock, you can't remove the Joy-Cons, anything like that.
Oh, it's permanently like that?
It is one solid piece. Yeah, which is why it's meant just for handheld mode.
Okay, so all right. So we're talking about $50 extra for an OLED screen, which for some people that is worth it. But here's the downside of this.
Yeah.
It's still a 720p screen. We're not even talking about standards today. Like
this. Yeah.
I'm gonna go back on that standards tangent.
there are a lot of like memes right now about this online, and it's basically saying like, this is the bare minimum.
Yeah.
Like Nintendo is going to charge you $50 more for the bare minimum.
Yeah.
And it's like, I only play my Switch in handheld mode if I'm traveling, and that's rare.
Right.
And like, that's it. Yeah. Aside from that, it's docked, and I have like a Switch Pro controller, and I play it on my TV. So this new Swole does nothing for me.
So this reminds me
I don't play
a
Splatoon.
Lot.
Yeah.
This, go on. This reminds me a lot of the gripes and the crap that we deal with on PC side, mm-hmm. because it's like PC gaming people are ruthless in letting you know that your product is crap. whenever somebody releases like a new GPU or a new processor
or like a Razer Blade laptop.
Oh, a Razer Blade laptop that promises crazy frame rates and all this other crap, yeah. But in reality, oh, thanks for the follow, Rom.
Numerals.
Yes. But here's the thing, like PC gamers are just they're relentless for this kind of stuff. Now console players are starting to feel the pain about, like, look, you know, we believed in you. I have like, we have the high ground kind of moment, right?
Yeah, like, it's like, you're my brother, Anakin!
You're my brother!
you're right, because, like, the Switch Lite has a purpose. The 2DS, if you remember that, has a purpose. It's like,
well, look what
that
happened.
That applies to a different audience.
Yeah.
This applies to the same audience, just in a new way.
So
that doesn't matter. And it's like, cool. Oh, also, speaking of the dock, you can buy the dock separately. So, like, the dock that has the Ethernet port in it, if you just want that, you can buy that separately.
Oh,
you
don't wow.
have to buy,
it's like,
you don't have
what?
To buy the swole for that. Like,
it's like, just, what, $100?
I don't even know the price.
That would be the shittiest thing for Nintendo to do, to be like, hey, you can buy this dock for $100 with the Ethernet, or you could just pay $50 more and get a brand new system.
I think it's like 60 or something. I'm looking it up right now.
Oh my god. Would you, I can only see, except for those without money problems, I can only see people who don't have a Switch who've been dying to get on a Switch by the OLED screen.
Yeah.
I don't see current Nintendo Switch, unless you're a collector or money is no object, buying another Switch with the OLED and all the upgrades. I just can't see it.
So, Nintendo did not reveal the price of the Switch OLED dock. So this is an article on MSN. The current dock sells for $60. The Nintendo branded Switch LAN adapter, which is just a USB to Ethernet, costs $30. So technically, you could just buy a dock and a USB to Ethernet, and it would be the same thing for $80. I'm curious to see what this new dock is going to cost. If it costs more than $80, Nintendo are geniuses, because they are literally just printing money at this point, and people are still paying them. It's like, if this Switch Pro dock costs $100, it's going to be like, I know so many people who are going to buy it just because it's branded with, like, Nintendo on it.
Okay.
And it's like, this is just insanity at this point. Like, I feel like I'm taking crazy pills.
That's literally what I was just about to quote.
Yeah.
Dude, are you kidding me? Like, yeah, granted, I buy some ridiculous stuff in the background, right? But it's just like, there's a purpose for it. And I have it running 100% of what it's capable of all the time.
And yes, I know I'm being totally hypocritical, because I'm the guy who buys 800 copies of the same game. I get it. You know, like, I get it. But this is one of those things where it's like, Nintendo, like, no, I'm not. Okay. I'm not. I don't need the Ethernet adapter. Yeah.
Yep,
I'm not the one to talk about wasting money with a 3090 purchase. Yeah, exactly.
It's shut your mouth, Joe Gensha.
It is worth every penny.
You only speak for yourself, not us.
Yeah, it's like,
yes, that money was worth it. Shut up.
It's totally worth it.
Ultra pixels.
Ultra pixels.
Shut up.
I wonder how he's doing now, Carmack. I wonder how, like,
sleeping on his money bed.
I'm sure he's sleeping on his money bed, yeah. but I mean, so, like, the Oculus, he's still at Oculus, right?
Yeah.
Like, doing the Facebook Oculus.
I assume, like, he's just, like, coming in, clocking in, and then going back home.
You know, like, I wonder what he's working on.
Like,
you know?
How much more of VR can you work on?
I don't know. I mean, like, so the Quest is selling.
Yeah.
People like it. It's like, I wonder if he's secretly working on, like, this new VR system that is going to revolutionize everything and make it affordable for people or something like that. I don't know. That's Romero. Yeah. And it's, dude, you know what? I'll be the first to admit it. I own Daikatana on PC and on the N64, and I've never played it.
That's probably a good option.
Yeah. which if I were gonna play it, it would be the N64 version, just so I could get the worst possible experience. Yeah. But
get
I've
those
never
20
played
frames
it.
A second.
Yeah, it's like, that's That's something that I still need to do at some point, is just so I can say I played it, you know?
Yeah. All right, let's move on to the next
John one. Romero can make me his bitch or something like that.
Yeah, since that worked out.
Totally worked out.
What a great PR plan.
Yeah, and you know, like, he had nothing to do with that, right? Yeah. It was like Ion Storm or whoever made that game. It was their advertising firm.
They wanted to come out hard and heavy. This. Yeah.
Yeah. We got this, bros.
Because Quake had just created this huge following for just hardcore Nine Inch Nails fans and whatnot. And it's just like, damn. So they had to up that ante at that point. Daikatana is going to be the shiznit.
The greatest game ever.
Yeah. So Atari Gaming, remember those guys? Long time ago. I mean, apparently they've been doing mobile gaming for a little while now, but they're deciding to go back into the big boys playroom.
So, full disclosure, I didn't even know they were doing mobile games.
I didn't even know.
Like, I know Atari's still around because they finally released their console, the VCS. Okay, and by the way, when we say Atari, I know everybody thinks back to like the 1970s and Pong and all that stuff. This is so far disjointed from that company. Like, the name Atari has been bought and sold so many times. It's literally just the Mount Fuji logo and the name.
Yeah.
And that's it. It's like, it would be like if EA bought it next and then just said Atari. You know, it's like, this is not close to the same company as back in the
70s. What it used to be. Yeah.
Yeah. But apparently current Atari, they have mobile games like Roller Coaster Tycoon Stories, Crystal Castles, Castles and Catapults, Ninja Golf, and Atari Combat Tank Fury. But they are basically going to jettison all of those mobile games because they want to focus on console and PC, which, like we said, they just released their VCS. Yogensha says it's pretty nice, not going to lie. All the reviews I've seen of it, I don't have one myself. I had no interest in their Kickstarter. All of the reviews I've seen, everybody's like, this is nothing you can't get on any other console. Like, why am I paying Atari for this?
Right.
It looks cool. It looks pretty as hell if you've ever seen one of these things. They even have one that has like the fake wood grain print, kind of like the old like Atari 2600. Really cool looking, but like the functionality of it, it's just a waste of time at this point.
So at this point, it just sounds like they're doing a giant reorg here, because it also says publisher will also exit Atari Casino and write down TV production efforts as it refocuses on premium PC and console titles. First, I didn't even know Atari had a casino division. I thought they were just like lending out their IPs to other companies,
like,
and just
they're like licensing
that
with gaming companies or something like that.
Konami is just like that. They actually did the opposite. They left the gaming industry and went straight casino.
Konami makes a ton of money off casino.
Right.
In America and in Japan, I'm sure all over the world. Pachinko machines, slot machines, all that stuff. They make a fortune off that. And they also release pretty crappy video games and then are wondering why they make so little money off their video game division.
I don't know.
It's like, we don't care, and we're going to put the bare minimum of effort in there, and it's going to make no money, and they're going to be like, video games are dying, bros.
I literally see the board meeting meme all the time whenever Atari is all like, all right, let's take our most popular IP and look at the current trends, pick one out. Zombies. Now we have Metal Gear with zombies.
Oh, Konami, yeah. Metal Gear Survive, which I've never played Metal Gear Survive. I remember when I saw the debut trailer for that, and it was instantly like, hard pass.
That was
so many passes happening.
It only lived for like about a month on Twitch and everything. It was just like, why am I doing this again?
Nobody cared. It was awful. It got booed out of existence.
Yeah.
So this Atari thing, where they said they're exiting the casino business in Africa and writing down its efforts to get in TV show production, if you recall, and this isn't part of the article at all, Atari also announced hotels. I don't know if you remember this.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Because Vegas, where we live, is supposed to get one.
And weren't they supposed to be like on Sahara in Las Vegas Boulevard or something like that? There was some.
I have no idea.
There was some casino that they were going to take the shell from.
Yeah, there's supposed to be one in Phoenix. And then after that, Vegas was going to start being built. And it's like, I'm sure COVID canceled everybody's plans. But as far as I know, the hotel thing never got officially canceled. So at some point that might still happen. But Atari focusing on PC and console, it's like the VCS, their new thing they just launched. As far as I know, it's not that widespread. It's not selling gangbusters like I'm sure they're hoping it does.
That's just their remake console, right?
Yeah, it's like it's a console that plays. It has like a built-in library of Atari games, which cool. Like it's an Atari console; they have the licenses, all that stuff, and it has built-in games, and then it has a subscription service that you can buy into to get more Atari games. So it's full of Atari games, and then one of the things they advertise is you can also play PC games on this. And it's like,
what?
Okay. But I was watching people show this off, like on YouTube, because I was like, hey, it finally launched. And there's all these like review videos. It has the capability of running Windows Portable. So basically, you have a hard drive or like a USB stick that has Windows Portable, that Windows Portable instance has all your PC games on it. So it's basically just like a holder, it's just like a launcher for your portable Windows instance that has whatever PC games you want on.
I can just imagine the compatibility nightmare.
Oh yeah, and I'm just like, this thing is a mess. Like, I don't. It's so unfocused. It's like I don't know what they're trying to do with this thing. But whatever, Atari.
I mean, you literally could have just VMware'd it, or just virtual machine it, and then just run it that way, and you would have been fine.
I don't know.
But whatever.
I don't get it. If it's like $50 on sale, I'll buy one just so I can say I have it for my collection. But I think it's like $400 something right now. Woo! And it's like, there's no way.
Nope.
There's no way that's happening.
$400? Nah.
Yeah.
I'll just buy myself a Xbox Series S at that point. Be done with it. And then it's $399 for the Series S, right? Or is it $299?
I thought it was $350 actually.
Well then, enough to get you a second controller plus tax. There you go. That'll work.
Or you can get that Switch OLED that swole for.
How about
for $350?
No.
Oh, $299 for the Series S? That's a good deal, man.
Yeah. Especially if you don't have like a fancy 4K TV currently. Like, there's really no point.
What I'm watching a lot is when Digital Foundry does their like big reviews of games on like the PS5 and the Series X, they always include the Series S.
Mm-hmm.
And the Series S actually gets pretty talked positively by them on almost every video. They're like, yeah, it's not 4K, but it runs smooth.
Right.
Like it doesn't try to be too powerful. And so it's like, yeah. They took the Series X version of the game and then just said, okay, don't reach for the stars on your resolution and frame rates. Yeah. So all of their games just run smooth.
Yeah.
And so I was that's cool.
It's basically the cream of the crop for the current gen televisions and not necessarily like next gen 4K stuff.
Yeah. If you don't have a 4K TV or you don't care or anything like that, the Series S is a really good option.
Yeah.
Especially with Game Pass.
Yeah, if you have 4K and that television is capable of 120 hertz, I mean, I think even 120 hertz you have to bump down to 1080, so what's the point at that? I know some of the LG models will let you do 120 hertz, but I'm still waiting till the prices come down because they're ridiculous.
All right,
let's go on to our next one. An update on Assassin's Creed Infinity, which I just heard today. And the future of the Assassin's Creed franchise. So, Assassin's Creed Infinity.
Infinity. Not to be confused with Disney Infinity.
And not to be confused with Halo Infinite.
Or Infinity War.
Ah. Yes. So many infinites.
I know. It's like there's an infinite amount of them.
Bum, bum, ba-dum.
Okay, so what this is the future of Assassin's Creed, is what they're saying. Ubisoft is basically done with the current Ass Creed model, which is like once every 2 years or something like that, they release a new one and it's like a 400 hour game with a million DLC packs. They're done. This is a, Yokenji calls it right here, this is a live service game. A lot of people hear live service and they think Destiny, or they think Outriders or Anthem, or, you know, like one of those type games. All live service means is that they just continually work on the same game. Like, they don't try to upgrade at all. There are rumors that GTA 6 is going to be a live service game. Fortnite is a good example of this, where they just keep tacking content onto the same game. So Ass Creed Infinity would basically be like, Ass Creed Infinity launches, and your first campaign is going to be whatever. I'm just going to say Origins. It's going to be back in Egypt. And then they're going to tool that and make like little missions and little campaign packs and little stories for you to do.
And seasons.
Then, yeah, seasons. Think seasons or battle pass type stuff. And then maybe in the fall, they're going to release Ancient Greece. So while you're stepping into the Animus, you basically say, where do you want to travel? Like, I want to go to ancient Egypt. I want to go to ancient Greece. I want to go to Paris. I want to go to the French Revolution. I want to go, yeah.
This feels like an attempt to just not have to rehash a brand new game from scratch every single year.
Yeah. Like I said, like Fortnite kind of changed the game on how these kind of games are made. They changed the game. That's a horrible thing I just said. They fans. That sounds better. Whatever. So like a lot of people are trying to jump on this bandwagon now. I don't know what it's going to look like. I gave up on Assassin's Creed years ago because it just turned into a horrible, horrible thing. And I haven't played the last few of them. So
is there an Animus in the latest games at all at this point?
From my understanding, no. Or it's like there are, the way it was explained to me, it's like, it does reference current times and Abstergo and all that stuff, but there's no like
storyline
current day person who steps into an Animus and then you have this.
So there's still a desyncing animation at that point?
I gave up when Unity came out, which is the one in the French Revolution. I gave up at that point. I was like, I'm out.
I always laugh at the memes that say, I'm done. Yeah. I laugh at the memes that say like, oh, Assassin's Creed back in the beginning wanted to take time for the game for it to be time accurate to that age, right? And then they're all like, yeah, you know, the finger and everything, the blade and everything needed to be authentic with the Templars and everything. All of a sudden I'm looking at these games and you have like horses that are on fire that are your mounts now. And it's just like, wait a second. Where was this?
It's like, did that happen? It's a Ubisoft game. It's never going to be real.
I mean, yeah, it just reminds me of Call of Duty, of how they want to play homage and press F for respects and all this other stuff. Yet you have like camo, friggin' flame camo, diamond camo on your guns that nobody else has or something like that. It's just like, dude, you're not paying homage to anything. You're just selling games. That's it.
Yogensha is half right here. Ass Creed 2 and Black Flag are the best ones. None will ever be better despite sales numbers. Ass Creed 2 is the best game in the series, hands down. Ass Creed 2 is a fantastic game. Black Flag, one of the worst. Sorry, you're wrong. Okay.
Really?
No. Black Flag was horrible. God. Jeez. What were you thinking?
Well, let's go on to the next one. Let's go on with Save Titanfall. And I don't know if anybody has been following this, but Apex apparently got taken over by a whole bunch of nerds trying to tell, I guess it would be, what, EA?
Respawn.
Fix Titanfall.
EA Respawn, yeah.
Yeah. So I didn't know that this was actually done in the game. But exactly how did they get that message across, Clay?
I have no idea. I don't know how it happened, but so what this is, and you'd be like, oh, those darn malicious hackers. These are the fans of the games who are hacking themselves. This is how weird this story gets. Basically, Respawn Entertainment, owned by EA, they made Titanfall a few years ago, and it was awesome. Remember, it was just the multiplayer-only experience.
Yeah.
And then Titanfall 2 came out, and it is one of the best first-person shooter campaigns you'll ever play in your life. And then it also had its multiplayer mode, and it's all that. Apex, same company. Apex Legends comes out. It's their free-to-play battle royale. It's really popular if you haven't played it. It's free-to-play, try it out, whatever. Apparently Titanfall 1 is still live. Titanfall 1 is still being played. Yeah. I didn't know that myself. I figured when 2 came out, people would just jump ship, right?
Well, I've been trying to find servers in there, but I can never find them.
Hence the problem you're having that they are. So yeah. Titanfall 1, apparently the PC version of Titanfall 1, I have it on the Xbox, and I'm kind of curious to try it out and see what happens. I might do that today. Like, I'll install Titanfall 1 just to see what happens. Apparently the PC version is unplayable. Because it's a multiplayer only game, and apparently it's so full of hackers that it's a horrible experience. It's unplayable, and there has been complaint after complaint after complaint, support tickets, everything for years, and Respawn and EA just don't care. Well, because why would they if Apex Legends is making all the
money? Well, here's the problem with that. They're still selling it as is.
They're still, and that's where this kind of comes into play. If you go to Origin, if you go to the Xbox store, or, you know, like the Windows store for PC or whatever it is, it's still being sold. It's still on Steam. It's still in Origin or EA Play or whatever they call it now. It's still being sold, and it's a broken game. Like, I can't wait to play that game, and then you'll never get into a game.
No, and they sell you the entire game, and there's no way to play without that multiplayer aspect.
Yeah, that's all Titanfall 1 is. There is no campaign. It is literally only multiplayer. So it's like, this is crazy. So basically, these upset gamers hacked Apex Legends to make all of the playlists you jump into say, save Titanfall. And it gave you a link to a website. If you go to, I think it's just savetitanfall.com. And it's basically them just trying to get the message out there, like trying to drum up some PR to say, like, yo, EA, Respawn, fix your game. And the response I saw on this, Respawn put out a Twitter update, and it basically said, you know, we're aware some people are having issues getting into their games on Apex. We're looking into it. And then a couple hours later, they were like, fixed. Whatever hole they had to patch, you know, like whatever happened, they kicked the hackers out. Apex is back online. Yay, Apex. What about Titanfall 1?
No.
Did anything happen?
No.
Did they fix it? Did somebody go, we should probably look at Titanfall 1, guys? You know, like, the reason this happened was because Titanfall's broken. We should probably fix it. No. Titanfall doesn't make any money. Get out of here. I'm very That's curious so to sad. See what's the response going to be. Are they going to delist the game? Like,
they have
a couple of options here. They can just stop selling it.
Yeah.
Hey guys, Titanfall 1 is out of support now. It's out of maintenance. We're not going to sell it anymore. If you own it, we hope you enjoyed it over the past few years. It's dead. Move on to Titanfall 2. Titanfall 2 is on sale for $5 all the time. Okay, like,
or at least Titanfall 2. At least give us some bullshit excuse that because of the way that it was built, it only works on these servers, and these servers are going out of service.
Yeah, it's zero. No one cares about Titanfall.
I care about Titanfall.
Well, then play 2.
But I like the original.
And I've played the original, and I've played like one game of multiplayer on 2. Is there a vast difference in the two?
It's not that. Now they just added the mechanics of you being able to do some crazy wall running on 2 more than you could on 1. You could still do it on 1, but
yeah, 1 had that. Yeah.
Yeah, you can still do that on 1. It's just there's a lot more. It takes more skill to be able to do those runs, I guess.
Okay. Versus, so it's like easier.
Yeah, it's easier to do it. But then not only that, but Titanfall 2 is more directly connected.
The grappling thingy.
Yeah. Titanfall 2 matches, their wall running matches more closely to Apex versus Titanfall 1. Okay. Which is why people love it. You can train hard on Titanfall 2 and transfer over those skills to something where you just don't have unlimited respawns.
I'm going to download Titanfall 1 on my Xbox and see what happens.
Dude, download it because it's on it's on Xbox Game Pass. So
Yeah. Which would... I actually got a copy of it a few years ago because it was $5. And I was like, why not? You know, like, why not? Sure, $5. But yeah, it is part of... If you have Game Pass Ultimate, which includes EA Play, you can get both Titanfall 1 and 2 on that.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's... Yeah, I'm going to try it on the Xbox just to see if it's broken on there. But yeah, so they can either fix it, they can delist it, or if they don't delist it, honestly, they're open to like a class action lawsuit at this point.
Right, right. And I think they know that.
Yeah.
And if anything, this might just be enough movement for them to be like, guess who's getting a remake? Guess who's getting an HD remake? You guys who were complaining about it, please stop hacking us. You guys.
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying. It's like, I have not seen a response on what they're going to do for Titanfall 1. I just saw Apex is fixed. Keep spending money. All right.
There you go. Keep us sending us that money.
Buy that new character or whatever.
Yeah. Dude, it's going to be ridiculous. I applaud the fact that they did this. Mm-hmm. We'll see where it leads, but I think lawsuits, money talks, right? So, like, bro, you're selling us a broken game, and you know it. You didn't even mention anything.
They are clearly open to some kind of lawsuit at this point, especially if these people who have been complaining have, like, support ticket numbers.
Yeah.
Like, I've opened 17 support tickets over the past year for Titanfall. Nothing's happened.
Yeah. And I bought this game legitimately, so...
Yeah, I bought this game on Steam for $20 or whatever, and it's like, yet to ever work.
I took a screenshot of everything that the game is capable of and what you are not representing of that game. And that's 100,000. Enjoy. Yeah.
Just all like right. Cyberpunk is going to get sued into oblivion. They already are. They have 3 class action lawsuits against CD Projekt Red.
That's a lot
of
money.
And it's all their investors.
Yeah.
It's all the people who directly fund the game.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, let's go on to something a little bit creepy for me, but check this out. New machine learning cheat threatens competitive console play. Mm-hmm. I thought that this might not come as fast on the private sector.
Yeah.
But having AI be able to learn, like, I don't know if anybody was aware back in the day, they were showing off AI where an AI bot would try to beat, like, in StarCraft, a whole bunch of different like pros, and it was amazing to watch, and it beat every single pro no problem. But then to start seeing cheats with that kind of technology in there, apparently they've taken notice, and now I didn't even know that they were advertising this. It's almost like saying, hey, I'm the crook, here I am, just go ahead and buy my stuff. They're starting to take them down.
This is all Warzone, which is what we're talking about here. Call of Duty Warzone, a cheat went online that this company, meaning it's probably like two guys in a garage, but like they created this AI, this machine learning thing that learns while you're playing Warzone, and you can adjust its parameters on what it gives. There's a whole video showing how this thing works, and I watched it. I was like, that's kind of impressive just for techie stuff, but like it sits in between you and the game, and it can do like your mouse or key or controller inputs for you. So it knows like when that dude is about to be around that corner, then instant headshot happens, like that kind of stuff. And it works on consoles as well. The company that's selling this, I don't even have the name of them. I don't have the website. All the articles I've read about this, which is like, this is a good thing. Every company who's had an article about this, they refuse to give out the name of this company. They're like, we're not going to tell you where to buy this thing. So like, F off. But apparently they started running ads on YouTube, and Activision struck down the ads. They basically said, no, you cannot sell cheat devices, whatever. They got Google involved. They pulled all the ads. Apparently this company, whoever they are, their Discord is still alive where they're still actively selling the cheats. So I don't even know who it is. But all I know is, hey, dirtbags, stop cheating.
I mean, their detection is crazy accurate.
Yeah.
It even gives them, like, trajectory, which some cheats can't do. You know how, like, when a subject is moving? It gives them trajectory of where they're going to be, when they're going to be there, so that way you can fire it off. And I'm just like, that is insane to be able to predict movement at that level. But whatever. I mean, I don't use cheats, so.
Yeah. Like, I ain't down with that, homie.
Sorry.
Yeah. It's just, you're not playing the game. It's not fun for me. But two, it's a waste of money. Right? Like, I'm not just going to throw away money on some cheat thing. That's stupid. But you just says, I guess the days when console multiplayer was mostly safe are now over. Back in the 360, Call of Duty cheating was crazy too through modified save games. Yeah, consoles have never been foolproof on cheating. Like, PlayStation 2 online was, everybody cheated that. The original Xbox, mod chips. They made it so you can cheat online games. You know, it's like, there's always going to be cheaters out there. It's just the consoles are usually a little tighter on controls.
Do you think it's because cheaters as people were never loved?
Like mommy never loved them.
Yeah, like they were ignored.
They're trying to find a way to be impressive, yes, and they're not.
I need validation from people, even though it's illegitimate.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of that, I saw this on Twitter. I haven't like watched the video or anything, or I saw like a little clip of it. Apparently I don't know if this is Modern Warfare or whatever, Black Ops or anything, or Warzone or whatever. There's some Call of Duty guy who got banned for cheating, and he claims he's innocent. And it's to prove that he was playing a game of Warzone or whatever Call of Duty game he plays with 5 cameras on him, showing all of his movements and everything like that. Like just so he can prove, like, no, I'm this good. And I was like,
how do you get mistaken for a cheater?
I don't know.
And I mean, unless you're doing some crazy like snapping and stuff like that, I can see that happening, because that looks a lot like an aimbot when you snap to a person. But if your aim is that good and you have a crap ton of cameras on you, I mean, there's got to be something wrong with the cheating. Unless you're just getting reported all the time, and they're just like, on average, you're getting reported 50 times out of every 100 games. We have to stop you, even though we didn't look at the footage. You know what I mean? Like, no, I'm good like that.
Yeah, it's like this guy, and I'm trying to find it. I'll find it later. But yeah, it was like this guy. Basically, he was like, no, like, look, like, this is in.
So like, clearly he had to make an alternate account because he already got banned.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, like it was just on my Twitter feed today, and I was like, what? That's crazy. Yeah.
Well, now that the pandemic is over, we're going back into con season. So you ready for a new one?
Yeah, we were actually going to talk about this last week before we got the show canceled, but it was like, what was it? PAX is coming back. Mm-hmm. PAX West, I believe it was. Mm-hmm. PAX West has already announced their dates, like ticket pre-sales and all that. Yeah, it's like basically conventions are coming back. Like people are going to be back in person again.
Should they though? I mean, it's the convenient of my room already. That's usually where I play video games as it is.
You and I have been to enough cons in the past where I'm good.
You think after the first time, the majority of people that go to cons are like, you know what? No, I'm okay.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know. Like,
it's a lot of walking, guys.
It's a lot of walking. It's a lot of smelly people. I don't want to go home anymore. I'm good.
Yeah. Just watch the.
I'm happy.
Just watch the webinar. Happy. You're fine with that. Trust me. They're not that great unless you're going for some like unlockables in your favorite game and they're just going to be there. Do those. But CD Projekt Red and Netflix are bringing WitcherCon coming July 9th, which
honestly, I think this was 99% Netflix, because if you look at the announcements they have on here, it's mostly Netflix.
Right. Well, that's where they released trailer for season 2 for this stuff.
Yeah, season 2 got a trailer. It releases. I know, Joe, you watched The Witcher, so yeah. I think it's December 18th or something like that. December 17th is when season 2 releases on Netflix.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is like their schedule. I think it's, yeah. They also announced an anime for The Witcher that's coming out in August.
Oh, I didn't even see that.
The anime, there's a WitcherCon, I believe it's over.
Yeah, it's over. It was over yesterday.
Yeah, I didn't watch it. But yeah, it's basically everything is streamed online, so like I'm sure you could find like a recap of it. But it was they talked about season two of the show. They talked about, so the anime, which comes out in August, is going to cover that character of all three games, actually, Vesemir, who was like Geralt's like brother in the School of the Wolf and all that stuff.
Right.
So it's going to cover him, which I thought that was really cool because he was a cool character. And then they talked about the only video game thing that happened was there was no Witcher 4 announced or anything like that. But basically what we mentioned earlier on the show, Witcher 3, which currently has the Game of the Year edition, is going to be Witcher 3 Complete Edition. And same as everything else, it's going to be The Witcher 3 and the two DLC packs, the Heart of Stone and Blood and Wine, which are fantastic. It's going to be all of those together, but also upgraded for the Series X and PS5 and Series S. So better frame rates, faster loading, better graphics, blah, blah, blah. Plus, they said, and they didn't say what it was, it's going to have some DLC added to it for the TV show. So I'm guessing it's going to give you like Henry Cavill Geralt.
Or oh, that'd like, be cool.
Or like the, if you buy the Game of the Year edition, which I have on the PlayStation, it's like there's alternate costumes for everybody. So like Ciri and Yennefer and Triss all have like alternate costumes. So it might just be like, and here's an alternate costume for Geralt. Now he looks like Henry Cavill or something like
that.
If you don't have The Witcher already, it'll be releasing sometime. Like this Witcher 3, you know, complete. If you already have it, it's a free upgrade. This is why people love CDPR, right? Like this is why they have that.
Please love us again. Please.
They're basically, yeah. So like I have a PS4 copy, so it'll upgrade to the PS5 whenever this thing launches. I spent 110 hours in that game. I'm not going to play it again, but like, but it's cool to see that like free upgrades are coming out.
Right. That's good though. I'm glad that they're paying some fan service, but is it really worth an entire con? Probably not.
That's what I'm curious about. So like, I know Witcher has a huge following and I'm sure it's a very popular Netflix show, but is it worthy of its own convention?
If Netflix is only talking about Witcher 3 and Witcher the series, no. But if you talk also, about all the games and all the books, then yes, that's worth it.
Yeah, if the guy Andre Zdarsky or whatever his name is, the author who created The Witcher, if he announced like a new book, that would be something, right? Yeah. I was gonna say, where is it? I think if it's still live, hold on, here we go. The Witcher 1. If you've never played The Witcher 1, it was free on GOG because of all this.
Oh, yeah?
And it's called The Witcher Enhanced Edition. Maybe, okay, the free thing might be over with unless it's free on somewhere else, but it's now $1.50 on GOG.
Still enough. Still worth it.
Witcher 1 free. This is yesterday. So it probably ended yesterday when the con ended.
Yeah.
But Witcher 1 was free. Witcher 1 was, it's good. I went through it. I went through 1, 2, and 3. It's an older game, so you just gotta put yourself in like a, you know, older mindset when you're playing it, but it's a really decent game. $1.50,
I can't wait for season two already. It's gonna be so awesome.
I still need to watch season one.
Come on, man, hurry up.
So we can talk about it at our wine and dine dinners.
I mean, when are we gonna have those?
Book club?
No, game club.
Like game Netflix club.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just,
I mean, you gotta watch it. I said this
before. I don't like, yeah, like what I said before, I loved those two DLCs for Witcher 3. I thought they were the best part of the game because I don't care about the storyline for The Witcher. I think it's a really dumb story. Yeah. So it's like, Geralt is a very boring character.
It's just, you know how deep people can get into the universe, right? Like, it doesn't have to be about Geralt. It can be about other things, and there's just so much lore into this universe that if you weren't even following Geralt, then it would be completely like World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
You know, there'd just be so much there. Because even if you look at the map for Witcher 3, that thing is gigantic.
It is huge. And if you play the Blood and Wine DLC, it's like a whole new giant map. It's like they basically gave you The Witcher 4 with that one DLC.
Yeah.
And that's why I loved it. I was like, this is the biggest freaking DLC I've ever played in my life. This is awesome.
Yeah, it's giant.
And it had its own story, which was better than The Witcher 3's story. That's why I was like, this is so good. This is one of the greatest DLCs of all time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But props to CD Projekt Red for that one. But that's pretty much it. I think they were showing off the anime here from one of the panels that you were talking about, the Nightmare of the Wolf as a mirror look. And this one's coming over to Netflix. They just showed you like some of the drawings for it. That's cool though. All righty. Well, that's our last game news article. So want to send it out there, Clay?
Don't I always? So, let me click on this button here so I can go back to looking at us. Okay. Sorry, I was looking at Overwatch League is on right now. I'm totally watching.
Yeah.
So, thanks everybody for showing up to Game News Live, brought to you by NerdJunkies.com. Joel, I think we have some social links, don't we?
Yeah, we got them over at NerdJunkies.com/social. You'll find them all there. And also make sure to join us, if you haven't already, to our Discord channel. Our latest member, Wunk Roo, who is also a, I think we were playing
Outriders?
Outriders. Last night, they were power leveling me through the game. Yeah. But I have a few more levels left, so hopefully we'll finally be able to get into some of the harder stuff and get some good loot. But yeah, if you want to join us on our Discord, we play games there all the time. And then we're on live every Saturday, mostly every Saturday. I've been taking a couple of vacations here and there.
Like the last weeks.
Shut up, Clay. All right, let's get out of here. Appreciate everybody coming by. We'll see you next time.
Bye, everyone. Love you guys.
See you next Saturday. Bye.
Bye.